Well, hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Brian, and today I want to show you guys my version of me trying to create this Mr. Heater Portable Buddy stove fan hack type thing. I've seen a bunch of videos on these online, and if you're looking at these Mr. Buddy heaters, you know that there's no fan, and these things are just radiant heaters. And in order to get the heat out to where you're sitting, it really helps to get some type of ventilation air movement pushing out, because these heaters get extremely hot, but all the heat rises up, you know, hot air rises, and there's not a fan built into this thing. So if you're sitting in front of it and you're more than 2 or 3 feet away from it, it's hard to feel the heat off of it unless you've got some type of air pushing that hot air to you. Long story short, I'm gonna put this fan on it to try to help push the hot air toward me. And these little fans here, I don't know what type of sorcery they have built into them, but they're stove fans and they require no electricity to actually turn. The only thing that it requires is heat coming up through the bottom of this thing. It's called a TEG motor, I believe, a thermoelectric generator. I think that's what it is. Don't quote me on it. But the magic of this thing is that once this gets hot enough, the actual motor starts to turn this blade. So there's a lot of guys that have used these things on the Mr. Buddy heater, and it works. So I'm gonna walk you guys through me actually trying to see if this thing works. I'm gonna cut the notch that I'm gonna use to put it in this protective grate to hopefully make it steady. Now, you don't have to cut this, but I'm going to, because I don't want it to sit sideways. So you can kind of stick it in here and it kind of stays up there, but to me that's not very secure. So I'm gonna try to find something that's gonna cut this. This is aluminum, and I don't really wanna use a grinder, but I might end up just doing that. I'm not sure. I've got a Dremel. I might even look at just using just a hand file. I don't know, but you just need to cut just enough, just a big enough slot in the back of this in order to get it to fit through there. So I'm going to walk you guys through how I'm going to do that, and you'll be the first test with me on video to see if this thing actually kicks on and works. So let's get going. So here's a bit of a close-up for you folks to see. So here's the fan, and what I've seen a lot of folks do is cut some type of slot, either in the front or the back, however you want to configure it. But I think I'm going to go through the back. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get this thing where it's kind of 90 degrees to the heater, and I'm going to mark where this is going to intersect the top of this grate right here, and that's where I'm going to cut my slot. And I'm going to figure out, I want this to be straight up and down, or as close to it as I can. So I pretty much know that I've just got to cut a slot going to start about right there. Now, I want this thing to go back. Let's start with about that far. So I'm going to make a mark right there. Okay. Now I'm going to go try to find some tool. I don't know what's going to be best for this application to actually cut a slot. Okay, so I got a couple, I'm going to try the grinder. I don't know if it's going to work, but I've got a couple of different grinding discs, and you can see the difference in thickness here. And I think this one's going to be too thin to cut a slot, to get a slot big enough to go over this grate. So this grate is actually thicker than this grinding wheel. So this is an 1/8 inch cutoff wheel, essentially, grinding disc. And I think I'm going to use this one because it looks about the right thickness to cut a slot in this, so I can slide it through there. So let's give that a try and see if my theory is correct. We'll cut that out. Okay, well, after that little camera mishap there, I think I got the slot cut in this thing. So you can see that 1/8 inch grinding wheel is the perfect thickness to use to cut to make it slide onto here. So let me give you guys a close up of what this looks like. So this is just simply going to slide on top and it's just gonna hold itself up. So it's not obviously a 100% permanent structure, but it's going to be on there good enough because this thing's gonna be sitting around. You're not gonna be carrying it around or anything. So let's get this thing started and see if the heat from this will actually power this little stove fan, and hopefully we'll get some heat movement. So let me go get a propane bottle hooked up to this thing and give it a shot. Okay, so right now we are looking at this thing is already at 380 degrees. Well, now this is showing. Right now we're at 446. So let's put this fan on here, see what it does. Now the operating temperature on this thing goes up to 650 degrees for this particular fan, so you really don't want it to get any hotter than that. And look at that, guys. Looks like it's going. That is pretty cool. So hopefully you guys can see that going now. And that is definitely pushing. I can feel the air pushing out now. So you can see what I did here in the back, hopefully. I just cut that notch. Okay, so that was pretty cool. That turned out to work out really well. Probably one of the easiest things you can do, and actually probably just using a file would work just as fine as you know, the grinder that I use. But as you can see here, this fan is definitely pushing out air, way more so than if it didn't have a fan, obviously, but it's pushing the hot air out instead of letting it escape up to the ceiling. So you can put this thing anywhere and actually have the hot air come at you. So really, really easy modification. It's unfortunate that Mr. Buddy doesn't put these on their heaters. I know the bigger ones used to have a fan in them, but it required some D-cell batteries, and I don't even think the new models come with that fan built in. This one never came with a fan, so just searching YouTube gave me this idea, but I wanted to show you guys just how easy it actually is to do this modification if you need to put some type of fan on your Buddy heater to get that heat moving toward you, wherever you're at. Super easy, and you know, I can't show you guys the airflow, but you might just have to trust me on this one time that there's actually some good amount of airflow coming off of it. It's not gonna blow your hair back or anything, but it's pushing enough hot air this way instead of up and up toward the ceiling. So really easy mod, super, you know, actually really, really happy with this thing. I think it's pretty cool. So I'll leave a link for this particular stove fan. I have a feeling they used to be a lot cheaper than what they are now. So I think I ended up paying like $40 for this one. And I saw some online that were upwards of $75, $80, $90, especially for the smaller ones with the two fans on them. Obviously I didn't get that because I didn't know if this would work, but I think this will be just fine for when I do need to use this. So anyway, guys, short, sweet, easy video. It works. I can confirm that these things do work, so, and really easy to do. So if you have a Mr. Buddy heater and you need some extra heat pushing out toward you instead of escaping up and away, there you go. Crazy easy. So until next time, guys, take care and we'll talk soon.